Hi, I'm John Hartley, salesperson with the RV Corral, and today I get to show you a new 2017 Winnebago Vista. This is the 29VE floor plan. It's a new floor plan for them, just came out this year, and really a nice family floor plan, lots of things you can do with it. You've got on this side, you've got an outside kitchen, an outside TV. This is really a neat feature in that, one, the refrigerator works on an inverter, so you have a 1,000-watt inverter on the coach, which runs TV, the refrigerator, the inside TV, some of the plug-ins inside. You've got great storage out here. This is kind of like a workspace here. You've got another area that can be a workspace or opens up to become a drawer. You have more drawer space. They even give you a thing for hanging a garbage can on here. Garbage bag, I should say. And nice opening cabinetry up here. There's a light that has two stages here, the dim and bright. Bottle opener, hot and cold running water here with a holding tank on it. They give you a cooler here for that has a drain in the bottom of it, so you can throw ice and your soda or beer in there, keep other things in here. And like I said, this is running on the inverter, so off the batteries, this fridge is still running. Most manufacturers doing a fridge back here, they only work when you're plugged in. And if you're tailgating, that's not something that's going to be happening. You've got a TV out here that's on a big swiveling mount, pulls out. Can be turned this way. This awning is 17 feet here. TV tucks back and latches into place here. Speakers from the TV or off the stereo inside. So you can have music or your TV sound out here. Some other neat things that they did. This goes up high and it's actually a two-stage strut. So if it starts raining, you can drop this down a little bit and use it as an awning. And then your main awning comes out over the rest of the coach here. And that's easily worked from right here by the door. Big power awning. Lots of nice space under the awning, your door's under the awning, your TV's under the awning. Then you've got, it does come with a barbecue and stand on the back of the coach. There's a place to hook this up as far as for the propane. Barbecue sits separate. And it does have full pass-through storage in this bay on it. Winnebago's really neat. One of the things that's really neat about them is that every piece has a part number. And when you visit Winnebago factory, they show you a warehouse that they have parts from every Winnebago built, and they can recreate or have in stock parts of any Winnebago, any age, going back into the 60s. So really a neat feature of Winnebago. Other things of Winnebago, just their quality and the way that they build an RV. This outside wall, for instance, a lot of RVs, when you look at it in the cold weather, you'll see the frame lines on it. That's because there's no insulation where the frame is. Winnebago product, there's insulation outside of the frame wall on it, so we don't get those condensation lines. You also get a warmer coach inside. Got lots of other storage. There's that inverter right here, and it turns on from inside. Some more storage right here. Notice how the Winnebago, all nice black finish to everything. This is what they call an E-coating, so it's electrostatically painted in a dip process. The whole sub chassis is done that way to prevent rust, and this is a pass-through compartment. Push that back up. Here's where that barbecue connects on it. Right here, so you can set your barbecue here near your kitchen, hook it up there, runs off the main propane tank of the RV, you don't have to carry any other propane. Rear monitor camera with night vision in it, so backing up, you know, when you get home and it's dark, you can still see where you're backing it into. The furnace back here. One thing that Winnebago's done is ran the furnace so the plenum runs straight down the middle of the coach, and they feel they get better heat out of the furnace system on that. Ladder up to the roof. The roof on a Winnebago is a fiberglass roof, so no membrane roof that can get damaged. Very nice feature there. Winnebago uses that fiberglass roof rather than a membrane roof. It is a full wall slide product, so you've got one slide opening. It is an electric slide and creates a ton of space inside and no tight areas in there. Your generator is a 4,000 watt Cummins Onan generator. Your shore cord is a 30 amp service on this, so small campgrounds and things, no problem to run a 30 amp on it. You've got some more. This is that other side of that pass-through storage. Your fuel fill is right here. Your waste compartment. So there's two gray tanks and one black tank. So your one from the kitchen here, and this is from the back kitchen. Then your black tank. Notice how clean and nice that Winnebago, well labeled. You have valves out here for low point drains, for filling the tank off of the pressure connection. This is where your city water connects to, and you can fill your tank from that. Notice how nicely the door is closed too. Just swing it closed, and then that's the other side of that main pass through. Water heater up here on the wall. Slide topper over the top of this one-piece slide. Leveling system is in here on it. Propane tank is down here. Winnebago also, this windshield is laminated into a steel frame. Winnebago Industries is the only manufacturer to date to have crash tested motorhomes. And this is one of the things that they learned, is to build a crash zone up in the front of this motorhome like many new cars have. Good headlight system. It's a Hella headlight, so it's a German made headlight system. Lights up the road good. Come on inside. Show you some other neat features. So just coming in the door, you got a place here, it's underneath the booth, but they put a little door here that, as you can see, works easily. Place to throw shoes, things like that. This coach has got the drop-down bed in it. There's a ladder that has a place that's stored, and what's really neat is that it's stored right under the front of the rear bed with latches here, and easy to put on. So just grab it from the back bed, slips right on there. This is a power lift and power up and down on it. They've given us some storage up front, and there is a child's netting up here. This bed is 48 inches wide, and so there's a netting up here to keep anyone from rolling off on that side. Ladder just lifted straight out and then pulls away. And then, like I said, there's a storage back on the back side of this clean bed back here. So power up on the bed over here. So press a button back here in the hallway and it raises the bed up. And they have a nice safety latch here, prevent it from coming down on you when you're driving. So dash area, this is the new Ford V10. So it gets the 6-speed automatic transmission in it with tow haul mode. The new 6-speed allows this motor to run about 800 RPMs lower than past years in these. So climbs the mountains better, it's not running so fast, and does a great job. Your backup camera and stereo is here. You have a nice little desk for passengers with power connections. You've got traditional plug in there and USB plugs both. I like the color that they've used up here. It's not overly light, and it's, you know, easy fabrics to take care of. This is a on it. Dinette is right here looking out the window into your main awning area. And Winnebago has used bypass windows, so you get much more ventilation on them. You've got screens, and the screens can be opened on them too if you need to hand things out there. A lot of new RVs have gone to this frameless window design. And the frameless window looks really nice from the outside, but it only opens a couple inches at the bottom, so you don't get much ventilation. So the big window size here, and then they've done roller shades on them. And they're the MCD roller shade. Everything in a Winnebago has got light switches, rather than having to switch them on at the light itself. We've got some counter space at the end of the, behind the dinette, and underneath is a big pull-out pantry. It faces to the back side, because they're assuming when you're cooking here that you're going to have access to your pantry. Got good counter space to it. Three burner cooktop with an oven. Microwave up here. And the cupboards have a shelf built in, and they're low enough where, well, as you notice, I'm not very tall, so I can see in these really easily. Lots of drawers, because you have two drawers here, all on metal glides. They're all wood drawers, positive latching, just pull straight out on them. You've got a cupboard under here, and then you've got four drawers in a row here, bigger ones lower. And then under the stove, you've got a nice big one for your pots and pans. That's something that so many RVs are missing, is a place for that's got the depth for pots and pans and things like that. Refrigerator here, and then more storage behind the fridge. Big deep cupboards. Nice drawer under the fridge. Big flat items, cookie sheets, or things like that. And the bathroom is placed right in the center of the coach. Nice mirror to it, good counter space, and we've got a nice big shower. And skylight in the shower, plenty of headroom. I'll step in there. So there, I can just barely reach the top, but plenty of room to move around in here. And again, wall switch here for your light. Bedroom back here, you've got your queen bed. As I said, there's a place for this to be stored. So pull up on the bed, and then this latches right in here on the front of the bed, out of the way. One thing you'll notice about a Winnebago is that they didn't use oriented strand board here. It's marine grade plywood. Same thing that Winnebago uses in the floor of their product too. You just don't see any oriented strand board in a Winnebago product. It's all marine grade plywood, which holds up much better and doesn't have that rough edge that catches on fabrics. Access to your water tank readers and your water pump easily from under the bed. Winnebago knows that things can happen, so they make the coach serviceable without being a problem to get to it and service it. Now your inverter does run the plug-ins back here in case you have a CPAP type of machine or something like that. Drawers on each side, cubby holes next to the bed up here. The bed seems high until you see there's a step up here, and this is over that kitchen area in the back. But you've got cubby holes. You've got more hanging storage, and these are real deep. You don't have the problem of the hanger not fitting. You got a drawer from each side, big deep drawer, all wood with a positive latch. TV back here. And then this whole thing lifts up, and it didn't waste the storage. They've got struts on this, made the TV a cabinet door. So you've got lots of storage in here. And there the TV, I hit the button while I was opening it, runs off the inverter because we're not plugged in right now. You got big drawers here, little vanity area with a window. So you've got some ventilation for your bedroom. Closet here, all three doors go into one closet area. I'd say it's around 4.5 feet of closet area. So a pretty decent amount of closet space. The slide being a full wall slide, there's nothing protruding into the room to trip over or anything like that when you look at this slide room. Winnebago places all of their controls in one place. So here we can read all the tank monitors. Here's our inverter operating, our heating and cooling system, the bed controls, and the slide control. Key to turn off the bed so that kids can't mess with it. This has got to have key on power up front to run. And nice big TV back here. And again, it runs on the inverter. So dry camped, you've got lots of access to everything without having to start a generator. The only thing you really need to start the generator for is the air conditioning if you're dry camped. If you're plugged in a park, don't have to start the generator at all. Again, my name is John Hartley. One of the best ways to reach me is my cell phone, and that's 541-953-5420. Be happy to answer any other questions. I'm sure there's other things I've missed that you may want to know about. Send me an email. I'm sure that's on the screen, johnh@rvcorral.com, or give me a call on my cell phone. That's 541-953-5420. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.
I bought my Winnebago through the RV Corral because these guys have been serving the state of Oregon and Lane County since 1988.
I bought my Winnebago because of the 50-year tradition of excellence that drives the RV market.
Well, ultimately, I bought because of the great service and help I was given.
I still purchase mine because of their tradition.
Service.
Tradition.
Service.
Tradition.
I guess we can both agree RV Corral is Eugene's number one dealer.